think we got a call. Hello?
Hi.
Hi. Who's this?
This is Pete.
Pete.
Hi, Pete. Do you have a homework question?
Yeah.
All right.
All right, great.
Stephanie,
well, let me go
yours.
To the board. What's your question?
It's about adding and subtracting radicals.
Oh, great. Okay, go ahead with your question.
Okay, it's 6 radical 3 minus 5 radical 2.
Okay.
Plus 3, radical 3.
Plus radical 3, all righty.
Plus 2 radical 2. Plus 3 radical 20.
Wow, okay.
Minus 7 radical 5.
Minus 7 radical 5. Okay, I couldn't even fit that on the board. That's so big of a question.
Yeah.
All right. All right, well, let's see what we got. What do you know about radicals so far, about combining radicals? Do you know anything about it?
Yeah, I know that you have to simplify them and you have to add them that are similar.
Right, similar. So I see a couple things similar. What do you see similar so far?
In the radical 3 and the 6 radical 3.
Good. So I'm going to be combining those together. Excellent. And do you notice anything else similar?
Negative 5 radical 2.
Okay. Good. I like how you said negative. You started to say negative because I'm going to think of that like a negative 5 radical 2.
Yeah.
And you said that went with the 2 radical 2. Okay.
Yeah.
What's up with the 3 radical 20?
It has to be simplified.
All right, wow, I like this kid. I'm going to simplify that one. So let me kind of go down here to the bottom, and let's work on 3 radical 20 for just a second. Let me get rid of that.
Okay.
All right, so we have to break down that 20, basically, right?
Yeah.
All right, so can you think of some factors that will give me 20?
Yeah. Four and 5.
Okay, so let me rewrite this. I'll have 3, and then I'll open up my radical, and I'll write 4 times 5. How's that?
Yes.
All right, good. So now let's go ahead and can I do the square root of 4?
Yes, and it's 2.
2. Okay, so I'm going to write times 2, but I still have that radical 5, right? I still have that underneath the square root.
Yeah.
All right, now what shall I do? I have 3 times 2. Radical 5. Can I do anything else with that?
You have to times the 3 times 2.
Good. And what do I get?
6.
Okay. 6 radical 5. Excellent. So
yeah.
That 3 radical 20 can really simplify to 6 radical 5?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So let's go ahead and since we're doing this on the board, I'm going to replace that with 6 radical 5. All right. And can I combine that 6 radical 5 with anything?
With -7 radical 5.
Awesome. Okay. So let's put this all together and see if we can come out with a final answer now. You ready? Let's start with our radical 3. I have 6 radical 3 and radical 3. So if I add that together, what do I get?
6 radical 3.
Well, remember, if I have a radical 3, that's like having one more to add on. So add one more to that, and you get
7 radical 3.
Good. Okay, so I took care of those. How about the radical 2s? I have -5 radical 2 and 2 radical 2.
Which equals 3 radical 2.
Okay, be careful though, because if I have -5, that -5 will make it a -3 radical 2. You're doing a great job. You really are. You're doing a great job. Don't worry about it.
I feel stupid.
No, don't feel stupid at all. You're doing an awesome job. We have to take care of our radical 5s though, right?
Yeah.
All right, so now be careful with this negative. We have 6 radical 5. And -7 radical 5.
-1 radical 5.
-1 radical 5. So is it okay
Yay!
If I... You got it. Awesome. Is it okay if I just write minus radical 5?
Yeah. Yeah, it's fine.
Okay, good. So our final answer after we did all our simplifying and combining will be 7 radical 3 minus 3 radical 2 minus radical 5.
I feel so smart.
You are so smart. You did an awesome job. That was a tough, tough problem. What grade are you in?
I love TV.
Oh, good. Well, I'm glad you got on TV tonight. That's awesome. Will you call us back sometime with another homework question?
Of course.
Oh, good, good.
I love you guys.
Well, thanks for calling, Pete.